Kia ora, and welcome to Heratong College's Junior Prize Giving. I'm Sam Walcott.
And I'm Piper Brambley, and we're your head students for 2022. Thank you for tuning in. This year has been one of ups and downs,
highs and lows. So please sit back, relax, and join us as we end the year on a high by celebrating the ups of this year's junior academic achievement.
As well as awards, this video includes speeches and musical performances. So enjoy the show.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, students, fellow faculty members. My name is Sean Blackler, the Year 9 Dean, and I have the distinct pleasure of reading out this year's Year 9 Potama Distinction and Pride Valley Awards. 9BR, Heath Broom, Ashton Caswell, Sophia Griffith, Michaela Hobes, Connor Isles, Chloe Jans van Vuden, Callum Jeffrey, Hunter Jones, Isabella Snow, Seth Staunton, Kayla Sutton, Alex Tice, Taylor Torrance, Renee Whelans, Riley Waitman, 9DG, Andrew Bold, Nikita Bryant, Charlie Fitzgerald, Waimarie Francis, Jazik Harris, Riley Kovacs, William McClellan, Kyra Ngarumu, Tui Puna, Olivia Pilkington, Caden Reynolds, Izzy Scott Little, Emmy Sosa Suarez, Ryan Sterling, Aria Waka, 9GL, Emily Evanil, Scarlett Betteridge, Hendrix Kodai, Tristan De Villiers, Atamaria Fowell, McKenna Falk, Claire Hayden, Connor Healy, Avisha Kumar, Sean Ray, Fintan Reek, Eddie Southwick, Abby Tudor, Molly Van Diggle, Case Ben Lewin, David Williams, 9LE, Kaipara Below, Jess Bowen, Leah Brinkley, Cassie Busby, Neville Charles, Aidan Coleman, Alex Connolly, Deanna Grindley, Emily Henderson, Michaela Hills, Kaimani Kennedy, Kahu Kōpū, Ephraim Lord, Ben Miller, Heidi Pierce, Jake Phillip, Lauren Quilty, Catherine Sofini, Ella Toms, Dre Gilbert, 9 SA. Mason Alexander. Kieran Barr. Jack Blackler. Manita Boosen. Tate Devlin. Tim Fernando. Marshall Kenny. Peyton King. Steph Lesicki. Phoenix Moore. Mishri Pettinger. Dante Pickett. Miriama Virko. Corey Windleburn. 9ST. Alex Bayer. Zach Carey. J.R. Colbert. Lily Foster. Samuel Hardy. Purinjay Cole. Cameron Chloe. Gracelyn Lata. Jack Mason. Hilton McCulloch. Amore McGregor. Ife Moses. Maya Parkin. Callum Whiteman. 9 SO. Manaya Biddle. Amber Buckley. Michelle Charles. Ben Ellison. Zaylin Harpy Marshall. Hunter Higgins. Cohen Hughes. Sebastian Johnston. Lila Martin. Ty Nem. Cavell Taramai. Angela Vong. Kira Wakefield. 9WO. Julia Bradford. Victor Christie. Laura Clark. Joseph Greeny. Ryan Hadley. Emily Hager. Audra Harvey. Hunter Jordan. Erin Knox. Jamie Lockhart Wallace. Jacob Mookie Hunter. Gemma Murta. Logan Parker. Tanya Preston. Kanish Sajwan. Lily Tarr. Molly Thayer. Tatum Wilmerins. The following are the recipients for the Junior Service Awards for 2021. 9BR. Ashton Casbolt. Michaela Hose. Hunter Jones. Isabella Snow. Taylor Torrance. Renee Whelans. 9GL. Asamarie Fowler. Eddie Southwick. Molly Van Diggle. Michaela Wellman. 9LE. Deanna Grindley. Ben Miller. Ella Toms. 9SA. Kieran Barr. Marshall Kenny. Steph Lesicki. 9ST. Zach Carey. Cameron Chloe. J. Jack Mason. 19. Cavell Taramai. Kira Wakefield. Maddie Williams. 9WO. Laura Clark. Jamie Lockhart Wallace. Lily Tarr. And Molly Thayer.
Kia ora koutou katoa. My name is Will Wilson. I am the Year 10 Dean and I will be presenting the Year 10 Academic and Service Awards today. 10AT, Aaron Callahan Mason, Cullen Donaldson, Grace Hull, Olivia Johns, Oscar McManus, Izzy McPartland, Jess Sharman, Kane Skelman, James Tarr, Anoush Upalapati, Victoria Walls, Christian Watson, Harrison Wood, Victoria Zimmerman, 10DS, Justin Broome, Kendall Cooper, Michael Dawson, Bella Fox, Julia Gray, Emlyn Green. Taylor Groot-Jones, Tyler Hill, Vader McGill, Kia McMartin, Ethan Murray, Hannah Prince, Hunter Sammons, Madeline Simmons, Maddie Thompson, Jared Wolcott, Jed Young, Tanachi, Adam Bennett, Caitlin Byrne, Mercedes Clearly Kerr, Aria Crawford, Annika Kelly, Rourke McKay, Brianna Martin, Brooke Moon, Tamani Murray, Matangi Honuku, Ben Rempala, Conard Rosenquist, Max Scrimshaw, Seth Skelton, Jeannie Fale, Jesse Whittle, 10HN, Madison Anderson, Jordan Barrow, Kyron Biddle, Victoria Clegg, Georgia Davies, Te Awanui Fowl, Holly Green, Carl Hayden, Caden Isles, Seth Kempton, Byron Lang, Daniel McGowan, Gloria McGillaniza, Yodan Padiachi, Charlize Snyder, Elijah Shatford, Paige Smith, 10HW, Brianna Adamson, Jodie Andrews, Dan Burke Flockton, Zaj Eruera, Terenzo Fremantle, Moni Henderson, India Hunt, Maddie Lowry, Paul McKay, Flynn Noble, Caden Patterson, Kat Roberts, Joseph Standeven, Oscar Irwin, 10MO, Koye Agunlejeka, Jade Burling, Jack Leary, Jess McGowan, Gabe Martins, Zach Moore, Varnish Narayan, Janish Patel, Kikisha Patel, Levi Shirley, Riley Tafirirangi, Tom Weir, Te Amo Wiltonaku, Kaziah Wills Toa, Tim Aramala, Teneso, Kayla Beard, Libby Davis Gates, Faze Hillman Hahua, Renee Houghton, Snehit Jumpala, Katie McCarthy, Danielle McClellan, Tiakitoa Nore Grace, Oliver Pellman, Sean Lloyd Salig, Lakshay Sharma, Ayush Sakur, Jade Whippy, 10WN, Emily Allori, Callan Admiral Stemper, Sophie Bradshaw Ross, Carl Dublin, Oliver Edwards, Madison Field, Yasmin Hannan, Dominic Jenkins, Jonathan Jones, Matt Jones, William King, Sean Mason, Naomi Moore, Emily Prince, Janaya Kelepaki, Tom Scarhill, Elizabeth Vamory. Year 10 Service Awards. 1080, Aaron Callahan Mason, Grace Hull, Olivia Jones, Izzy McPartland, Alice Parker, Victoria Zimmerman, 10DS, Bella Fox, Julia Gray, Emlyn Green, Tyler Hill, Vaden McGill, Hannah Prince, 10HE, Caitlin Byrne, Maddie Casbolt, Brooke Moon, Martangi Honoku, 10HN, Madison Anderson, 10HW, Moni Henderson, Kat Roberts, 10MO, Jade Burling, Janish Patel, Tinkisha Patel, Levi Shirley, 10SO, Libby Davis-Gates, Renee Houghton, Casey McCartan, Sean Lloyd Salig, Jade Whippy, 10WN, Emily Allori, Callan Avenal Stemper, Carl Devlin, Sean Mason, Naomi Moore, Sebastian Prange, Emily Prince. Japanese Trivia Competition, Callan Avenal Stemper, Maddie Casbolt, Michael Dawson, Oscar McManus, Brianna Martin, Yodan Padiachi, Janish Patel, Elijah Shatford, Riley Tafirirangi, Ayush Thakur, and Jade Whippy.
Kia ora koutou. To all of you out there watching, staff, students, and whānau, welcome. Once again, a very different year, and certainly a very different ending. But we are here to celebrate the achievements of our young people this year. As a region, we are so lucky to have more freedoms than other parts of the country, and I know many of you are thankful for this every day. Now we are in the COVID protection framework, the traffic light system. We have to learn to live with the virus as it will enter our community. The new framework is to allow us to suppress the virus. It will allow us to remain open as a school and to prevent future lockdowns. This year was the beginning of our much anticipated new junior curriculum, which has been about 5 years in the making. For our Year 9 students, it was nothing new. For our Year 10 students, it was quite different and challenging and sometimes hard work. But it's a huge step in the right direction. And with our whole school reflection, it is, of course, evolving. We have had many visits from other schools who are so impressed with our changes and, more importantly, the work that our staff have done for this change. They can see that we are innovative, responsive, and agile in our curriculum development. As we continue this year, we have had phrases that signify New Zealand's response to COVID-19. Be kind, stay safe, keep your bubble, team of 5 million, all great.
These all apply to the recent public health order that mandates all staff in registered schools who have contact with students to be fully vaccinated by the 1st of January 2022. Pretty hard not to have contact with students in an overcrowded school. As a school, we have done really well. And I know that as a region, Greater Wellington has the highest percentage of fully vaccinated teachers in the country, 98.3%. What an amazing achievement. As we look to the future, we also have changes to our school environment. We finally have four new teaching spaces available from the beginning of next year, and another four teaching spaces to arrive in 2022. I cannot say when they are coming. At the beginning of 2022, the school will be sitting down with the Ministry of Education to begin planning for the future and any role growth. This will involve the whole school community, so please make sure that you add your voice to the responses and ideas. We will be in contact with you in Term 1 next year. To all the Year 9 students, you are why we are here. Thank you for coming to school, working hard, supporting each other and us, and every day surprising us with the fantastic ways that you enact our pride values. Participation, respect, integrity, determination, and empathy. We have not been able to finish 2021 with the usual gatherings and celebrations. Hopefully, we will remember the smaller events that we have been able to celebrate, and that includes this video of prize giving. I know you're all desperate to start your summer holidays, so enough said. Please, everyone, have a well-earned break over summer. You all need it, and 2022 is again going to be quite different for us. Ko Fiona Craven Tokunwa, nō reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā tātou katoa, kia ora.
My name is Evan Sutherland. I am the SLT member in charge of Year 10, and I have the privilege of reading out the Maʻitaʻi and Manaakitanga awards for each one of the Pride classes this year. Our first student has exemplified the Pride values with enthusiasm all year, has been an active member of the school community, participating in the school production, taking part as a student librarian. She is a member of the Phoenix Carol and Music Roadshow, and even assisted Upper Primary School in moving classrooms. The Potama Award for Maʻitaʻi for 9BR goes to Isabella Snow. Our next award winner participates and is highly active in school life. He is spoken of highly by many of his teachers for his outstanding attitude. He volunteers in activities around the school and in class. He is considered to be a mediating influence and a positive influence on those around him. The Maʻitaʻi Award for 9BG goes to Jazee Karras. Our next recipient is a very strong athlete within the school community. She has participated in volleyball, the Upper Hutt Sports Exchange, netball, junior netball tournaments, the Horowhenua College Exchange, futsal for junior girls, basketball for junior girls. In addition to this, she has been awarded her Bronze Pride Award and has received many positive KMAR comments throughout the course of the year. She is an active participant throughout the school. She participates regularly in class. The Maʻitaʻi Award for 9GL goes to Claire Hayden. Our next recipient is another active athlete in our school community. She has been involved in many sports, including women's hockey, karate, inline skating, ice skating, football, and soccer. She also participates in sports outside of the school, being a part of her church sports camp, as well as the Horowhenua and Upper College Exchanges. She is considered by her teachers to be incredibly polite, active, and enthusiastic in her classes, and has also received her Bronze Pride Award this year. The Maʻitaʻi Award for 9TN goes to Michelle Charles. Our next recipient has exemplified the school's pride values throughout the course of the year.
She has been an active member in sports such as cricket, badminton, and represents the schools well in all of these. She has received her bronze and silver pride awards this year, as well as 2 pride postcards for the number of positive Kmart entries that she has received throughout the year. The Mai Tai Award for 9LE goes to Casey Busby. Our next recipient, as a surprise to no one, is a very active member in both athletics and other opportunities here at the school. He has been involved in badminton, bowls, lawn bowls, futsal, has participated in both the Upper Hutt College and Horowhenua Exchange. He's an active member of the school's Pride Council, has received his Bronze Pride Award already this year, as well as a Pride postcard from the number of positive Kmart entries that have been awarded to him. He's a very active member and is spoken highly of by many of his teachers. The Mai Tai Award for 9SA goes to Marshall Kenny. Our next recipient joined Hiratonga College late in the year, transferring to us from St. Warren's College. Since doing this, she has become a very active member within the school. She's spoken of very highly by all of her teachers. She has excelled in her classes and participates as an athlete in girls football, volleyball, as well as the Upper Hutt Sports Exchange. For being here for such a short time, she has accomplished a great deal. The Mai Tai Award for 9ST goes to Lily Foster. Our final year 9 recipient has exemplified the pride values throughout their first year at Hiratonga College. She has already received both her bronze and silver pride award, as well as 3 positive pride value postcards for her over 30 positive Kmart entries that have been entered about here by her teachers. She is also an active member of the futsal and football teams. The Mai Tai Award for 9WO goes to Laura Clark. Our first year 10 recipient is an active musician at Hiratonga College. She is a member of the chamber orchestra and production band, but has also participated in the wider school community as a member of the Pride Council, assisting with the Book Fest, as well as the Upper Hutt Primary School move. She has gained her silver pride badge this year, as well as a pride postcard for the number of positive Kmart entries that have been entered about her from her teachers. The Mai Tai Award for 10AT goes to Olivia Johns. Our next recipient of the award is an active athlete within the school. She has been a phenomenal contribution to many of the following sports teams, including basketball, dragon boating, football, futsal, the Horowhenua and Upper Hutt Exchanges, and also has participated in the Outward Bound program. She has received her bronze pride badge this year. The Mai Tai Award for 10DS goes to Olivia Grinter. Our next recipient consistently adds value to the school just by her presence. She is an active person involved in many of the school's activities and sporting events. She has been involved with volleyball, netball, the Horowhenua Sports Exchange. She also attends the Nainai Boxing Academy and has participated in the Outward Bound activity. In addition to this, she contributes to the wider school culture by participating in Relay for Life, Kapihaka, Ignite Sport Leadership, Phoenix Carol, the Music Roadshow, and more. She has received a Pride postcard for the number of positive Kmart entries that she has received this year. The Mai Tai Award for 10HE goes to Matangiho Nuku. Our next recipient has been an active member in the culture of the school and has worked with a new addition to our school, which is the Kickstart program. She is an active volunteer, constantly participating in her classes and is spoken of highly by her teachers. She has been involved in Outward Bound, working with the Kickstart program, Relay for Life, as well as other additional activities. She has received her Silver Pride Award this year, as well as a Pride postcard for the large number of positive Kmart entries that she has received from her teachers. The Mai Tai Award for 10HN goes to Madison Anderson. Our next recipient is an active athlete in the school. He has participated in many school activities and adds values to all of the classes that he is in. He is considered to be someone of worth by his peers and his teachers. and has been involved in cricket, football, the Upper Hutt Sports Exchange, and Porofinowa College Sports Exchange. In addition to this, he has participated in the school's Outward Bound program. The Mai Tai Award for 10HW goes to Dan Burke Flockton. Our next recipient has been involved in a variety of different activities throughout the school. She plays badminton and bowls for the college, has received both her Gold Pride and Leadership Awards this year, and has participated in the Gute German competition. The Mai Tai Award for 10MO goes to Tinkisha Patel. Our next recipient is an active athlete within the school to the extent that reading out all of the sports that she has been involved in this speech is far too long. An example of some of the sports that she has been involved in are netball, basketball, volleyball, sevens, and both of the school's college sports exchanges. In addition to this, she's an active member of the school's Kapa Haka and Poly Club group, and has also stepped up even as a junior student to take on the role as an assistant house leader. The comment that was written about her was that she has excelled as a Rumataka house leader and did a fantastic job teaching the house song to other students. This was a difficult challenge, but she rose to it, and for someone in year 10 to do this early, that is excellent. The Mai Tai Award for 10SO goes to Faze Hillman Hohua. Our final recipient for year 10 participates in the school both up front and behind the scenes. He has been involved in the production band, but has also helped as a sound technician behind the scenes in order to make sure that everything sounds great for the productions that are going out. He's an active member of the Pride Council. He participates in the Pride classes as well as the Japanese quiz that happened this year. And one special thing that he does is he creates a video for his Pride class every single year. This is something that he does without being prompted, but it has always been a very nice and special surprise. The Mai Tai Award for 10WN goes to Kaylin Avenel Stempa. We'll now move on to the Pride Manaakitanga Awards. Our first recipient always tries the best in everything that she does. She participates to her fullest in the Pride class, her normal classes, and all Pride events. She is an active volunteer helping out as a student librarian, working in the school production, is a representative on the Pride Councils, and has received her Bronze Pride Award this year. She has also received a number of positive KMAR entries. The Manaakitanga Award for 9BR goes to Renee Wellens. Our next recipient has exemplified the Pride values through his participation in sport. He actively participates in football, the Porofina Exchange, and the Upper Hutt College Exchange. He is a mediating force amongst the other students and is considered to be a positive influence on all of those around him. He has received his Pride postcard this year for the number of positive entries that have been given to him from his teachers. The Manaakitanga Award for 9DG goes to Riley Kovacs. Our next recipient has exemplified the Pride values this year at school. He has received and worked through his Bronze, Silver, and Gold Pride Value Awards. He has received a number of positive KMAR entries and is spoken highly of by his peers and teachers. He is considered to be a positive influence throughout the school and is a constant volunteer both in and out of the school. He assisted in the Upper Hutt Primary School move and has also joined the Student Volunteer Army. Manaakitanga Award for 9GO goes to Eddie Southwick. Our next recipient is considered to be an incredibly reliable and trustworthy member of the school. They always put their best effort forward and are willing to assist anyone who needs their help. They are an active member of the school's badminton and volleyball teams and have received their Bronze Pride Award this year. In addition to this, due to the large number of positive KMAR entries they have received, they have also received their Pride postcard. The Manaakitanga Award for 9TN goes to Cohen Hughes. Our next recipient has been an active member in both sports as well as cultural events here at the school. She has received excellent feedback from her peers as well as the staff of the college. She has been involved in the school's volleyball, futsal, and netball teams, and has also participated in the Gute German competition, assisted with open evening in order to promote German, helped with the Upper Hutt College Primary School moved, and achieved her Bronze Pride Badge this year. The Manaki Tango Award for 9LE goes to Deanne Grindley. Our next recipient has shown themselves to be a leader within the college. They are considered to be very reliable, trustworthy, and a positive influence on all those around them. They are an active member of the Pride Council. They have participated in Ignite Sport Leadership, as well as the Outward Bound course during the year. The Manaki Tango Award for 9SA goes to Tate Devlin. Our next recipient has excelled in both their participation and academics this year. He is considered to be a friendly, kind, and supportive student, and has exhibited the pride values throughout his time at Hiratonga College this year. He is a positive influence on those around him and has received many positive KMAR entries concerning his behavior and achievement. In addition, he has received his Bronze Pride Award and is currently achieving at NCA Level 1 in mathematics. The Manaki Tango Award for 9ST goes to Jack Mason. Our final Year 9 recipient embodies the pride values in everything she does. She has participated in school netball, the Portofino Sports Exchange, and Upper College Sports Exchange, but is also a student librarian, has been an active member of Relay for Life, and has received 2 pride postcards for the number of positive KMAR entries that she has received. In addition to this, she has also been awarded her bronze and silver pride badges, despite only being in Year 9. The Manaki Tango Award for 9WO goes to Molly Thayer. The first of our Year 10 recipients is another person showing exceptional leadership here within the school. They attempt all activities that are presented to them and rise to meet all of the challenges that are set out before them. He actively participates in his school-based activities, but has also been a part of the Duke of Edinburgh Bronze Group. He has been awarded a Pride postcard for the high level of positive KMAR entries that have been entered about him over the course of the year. The Manaki Tango Award for 10AT goes to Aaron Callahan Mason. Our next recipient is considered to be a role model here within the college, not only to the fellow Year 10s, but to all students. She is highly engaged, has a great sense of humor, is emotionally intelligent and superb manners. She is spoken of highly by her fellow students as well as staff members, and has been actively involved in many of the school activities, including football, cricket, dragon boating, the Tough Guy and Girl Challenge, and both of the school sports exchange. In addition to this, she has been involved with Kickstart programs, Outward Bounds, has received her Bronze Pride Award, and has also had so many positive KMAR entries that she has received postcard recognitions for those. The Manaki Tango Award for 10DS goes to Kendall Cooper. Our next recipient has exemplified the pride values throughout their time here at Hiratonga College this year. She is considered to be a very empathetic and respectful person and has been involved in a lot of activities both in and out of the school. She has been involved in Ignite Sport Leadership, the school sports exchanges, participated in Upper Hutt City Council forums, the Pride Council, and is an active member of the 9i Boxing Academy. In addition to this, she has received the Pride postcard for the number of positive KMAR entries that she has received this year. The Manaki Tango Award for 10HE goes to Brooke Moon. Our next student has also exemplified the pride values throughout their time at Hiratonga College this year. He is always an active participant, both in and outside of the school, and has received his gold and silver pride badges this year. In addition to this, he has chosen to join the Student Volunteer Armory and is currently working towards the badges that are associated with that. The Manaki Tango Award for 10HN goes to Cole Hayden. Our next recipient is an incredibly positive individual here at the school. She is constantly smiling, walking around with a very positive sense about her, and repeatedly refers to many of staff members as her besties. She has exhibited the pride values and is spoken highly of by staff and fellow students. She is both active inside and outside of the classroom. The Manaki Tango Award for 10HW goes to Maddie Lowry. Our next recipient is an active athlete and a growing leader within the Year 10 group. He has a positive influence around those around him and is spoken of highly by his peers and his teachers. He exemplifies the pride values and does everything that he can with kindness and to the best of his ability. He is active in the school with the Ignite Sport Leadership Program as well as the school's football team. He has participated in both of the school's sporting exchanges and is excelling in his education. The Manaakitanga Award for 10MO goes to Koye Agangelika. Our next recipient has exemplified the pride values and is a role model for his peers. He has worked to the best of his ability in everything he has done, both inside and outside of the classes. He is an active member in school's basketball, volleyball, and badminton teams and has participated in both of the school's sports exchanges. In addition to this, he has participated in Relay for Life and the Outward Bound program, has achieved his Bronze Pride Value Award, and due to the large number of positive KMR entries, has received his Pride postcard. The Manaakitanga Award for 10SO goes to Sean Lloyd Salik. Our final recipient is spoken of very highly by both the staff and the students. He is considered to be a highly active participant, respectful, empathetic, and demonstrates all of the school's pride values in everything that he does. He has participated in the Ignite Sport Leadership Program, Outward Bound, and has received his Pride postcard for the large number of positive KMR entries that he has received this year. The Manaakitanga Award for 10WN goes to Matt Jones.
Kia ora koutou katoa, ko Siobhan Paikahau, and I am one of the deputy principals here at Te Rerotonga College. And it is a great pleasure and privilege to be able to announce today the special and supreme awards. The Rose Ellender Cup for contribution to junior music goes to Olivia Jones. The Catherine Bland Trophy for contribution to performing arts goes to Manaya Biddle. The Junior International Languages Award for Japanese goes to Janish Patel. The Junior International Languages Award for German goes to Jess Sharman. The Judy Griffiths Award for Top Junior Māori Student goes to Brooke Moon. The Ngā Manu Kōrero Award goes to Matangiho Nuku. The Kapa Haka Most Improved to Ururoa Haka goes to Tarati Horn. Te Waka Arurea Contribution to Culture goes to Matangiho Nuku. Our next Supreme Award is the Regional German Oral Competition at Victoria University. Two of our students competed against five other schools. These two students were tested on their understanding and ability to read fluently and accurately in German. This is a really amazing achievement, and our Year 9 student, who placed third, was Deanna Grinley. Our Year 10 student, who placed second, was Tinkisha Patel. So well done to those two girls. The next Supreme Awards go to the Top Year 9 Academic Achievement Awards, and this is for the top 8 students in Year 9. They are Casey Busby, Emily Avenel, Molly Thayer, Victor Christie, Samuel Hardy, and Mirama Vakwe. And the Supreme Award, the R.F. Wright Merit Cup for Top Year 9 Boy, goes to Corey Windleburn. The R.H. Slack Merit Cup for Top Year 9 Girl goes to Manita Buzzin. The next Supreme Awards are for the Top Year 10 Academic Achievement Awards for the top 8 students in Year 10. They are William Keane, Brooke Moon, Naomi Moore, Emily Allori, Bella Fox, Matangiho Nuku, and the Upper Hutt Chamber of Commerce Merit Cup for Top Year 10 Boy goes to Oscar McManus. The Upper Hutt Chamber of Commerce Merit Cup for Top Year 10 Girl goes to Jess Sharman.
And with that, our junior prize giving has come to an end. Thank you all for watching and showing your support. To the Year 9s, congratulations on making it through your first year of secondary school. You have already made the most of every opportunity. So going into Year 10, continue to be all that you are and make sure to always be on hand to help out the Year 9s coming through.
For you Year 10s that are entering our senior school next year, NCEA isn't as daunting as it sounds. Just make sure to engage with your work, teachers, and keep on top of your studies. Don't leave things till the last minute. You will all be stepping up next year, not only in our school, but in our community life as well. Continue to be role models for the young students, but most importantly, enjoy every day and take time for self-care when it's needed.
Mr. Paul Patterson, a former principal of Ferguson Intermediate, at his end of year speech, used to say that you can't soar like an eagle if you surround yourself with turkeys. So to conclude this prize giving, my advice to you is to watch who you surround yourself with and don't let the turkeys bring you down.
We hope you will have a fantastic break and we'll see you in 2022. Kia kite anō.